first question, which actually no one asked, but I'm going to ask James. What happened to our main quest launch, James? Why are we delayed?
Yeah, James has left the group chat. there were some technical issues, mainly with the integration of Passport Wallet on the Layer 3 site. So I think some of you saw that there was this invalid signature kind of issue. So this was kind of a little bit of a snag on the integration of Passport Wallet. They're working on it. Everyone's aware of the issue. They have a solution, so they're on top of it. But the great news is that we will be going back live on the main quest starting Friday. So the campaign will be extended. It originally was 2 weeks, so they will be giving us 3 weeks. So we'll be getting 3 weeks, an additional week of visibility to our project and driving more traffic and users and demand and player liquidity mostly into the game. And additionally, there's some strong possibility that we would have another season once Layer 3 capability has been reinstated with Passport Wallet. Then we'll have another chance to have another cycle. So, amazing. So sorry about that. It was a bit of an issue, but it's technical glitch as expected. And yeah, we'll be live again Friday.
Right. Right. So buy one, get one free kind of thing.
Yeah. Two main quests. Okay. So double the gems.
Amazing. So I'm just going to now go down the questions. So the first question.
Maybe if I just put one more addition on that main quest is all of the progress that we've been doing today still will count toward the main quest. So just because there was a small issue on the gems claim doesn't mean that your progress won't count. So the quest will be easier because you guys have had a head start at achieving that.
Yeah, amazing. And that's for everyone who's already joined up before or after last Monday. Okay, cool. Yep. Thank you, James. Okay, first question from DeFi Hodler. Even after claiming the starter pack, holding the OG collection NFTs should still have value, not just be a PFP. Continue to hold the OG NFT should increase the player's multiplier on cards and gems that you receive when opening a case. It should also decrease the wear on your queues. Holding more OG NFTs equals more gems and cards and healthier queues. This way, the OG NFTs will still be worth something after you claim the starter pack. Can you please make this happen? Thank you for the question, DeFi Hodler. Maybe we should let James answer that one.
For sure. So even after claiming the game starter pack, the PFPs will still have value. So if we remember, there was three kind of main things. The first one was the exclusive content around the queues, the game starter pack. So the game starter pack will claim a queue. This will be exclusive to OG NFT holders. And any cosmetic applications inside the game will also be exclusive to that. But even after the claim, you will still be enjoying this benefit. There's also the benefit of lifetime ad-free. So if there's when there's some advertisement integration, you will be able to enjoy those benefits without the advertisements. Early access to the beta. So this was part of the original functionality or utility, but it also would extend to future titles. So if there was another game that rolled out using similar platform that we're developing the infrastructure for, such as the physics engine, the peer-to-peer marketplace, and so on, the economy around it, this would give you early access as well. So it's a way that we can identify our early cohort of supporters and we can extend all of the benefits that we have for any future titles, any future NFTs that are needed to play those games or airdrops or so on. We will be able to identify you by the NFT holding of the original. So there will definitely be value to that as well. Yeah. And then, of course, the NFTs will be of different rarities and the gold as well as the gems for the starter bag. Yeah. I don't know if there's anything else you wanted to add on, Zen. I think I covered it.
So from my understanding, we're going to still keep the PvP or the exclusive cosmetic components. We get the lifetime ad-free access, right? We get, obviously you got the early access to the pre-launch beta now, and then this NFT is going to yield you a new NFT queue, which will have the equivalent rarity, right? And you're going to get the gold. So there is still value that lives on after that, right?
Yep.
Understood. Okay, got it. Okay. Why is Wyvern King a legend?
Yeah, that's a good question. I also agree. I think he is a legend for keeping the fort down when we're away. So he's running Discord, capturing all of your feedback. So all the feedback you guys like complain about, anything you mention in the general chat, he's writing it down. He's summarizing it, and we have a weekly feedback review of the community and all the things that say, hey, we see this commonly come up in the chat. It's probably something we should look at. And so all that feedback is going through him. So that's why he is king, right? So he's the voice of you guys, the community. So be nice to him, be kind to him. But yeah, he's letting us know the boil down pulse of the community.
I also have a theory that Croc Lion might just be Wyvern with a different account name as well. He's just giving himself a
Don't start with multi. Okay.
He's joking, Yanni. Third question, DeFi Hodler. Is there any way that we can have a weekly contest, something like player that plays the most total time gets coins or diamonds added to their account when it gets announced at the AMA, something fun or creative like that? Great. So I think you're kind of reading our mind right here. Short answer is yes, we are working on something. We're aiming to get this live around the end of September time, but we're going to release a feature that's going to bring a lot more excitement on a weekly basis, going to have an additional way to boost your rewards, and we're going to try to wrap that up in like a weekly highlight. So, you know, we're going to really showcase, you know, the best players, who's moved the most in the, not going to say rankings because we're sort of going to update that a little bit, but short answer, yes, we're working on it. Hang tight. Really excited to launch that feature end of September time. Next question, DeFi Hodler again. When snapshot? When will the snapshot be? If not determined yet, will you be giving everyone a heads up or several weeks before snapshot? Yes, target date for the snapshot is going to be December. We will give you guys more heads up as well. That's quite a good point, actually. Maybe we could build a feature where we have a countdown timer on the snapshot. Yes, so target date is December. We will give you a heads up. And actually, maybe we should consider building just a very quick feature to have a countdown. Okay, DeFi Hodler, more questions from you. OG starter packs rarity. So I had a quick look at all these questions beforehand. I think the next three are kind of hinting on the same theme. So can you please confirm the starter packs will provide larger coins and diamond gem emoji amounts of an other item based on rarity? Example, la 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 la. And then there's another question around reset from Zanella Sniper. Will reset earnings when the full version is released? And then there was another question from Keys31. I think it was mentioned before that your queues plus their levels / cards would carry over. Would be great if you can confirm, but will gems also carry over and gold, will they be reset? So I think this is really, all three of them are a question around what happens to your progress, right, in your pre-launch beta in the worldwide launch. James, do you think you can illuminate on that theme for us?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, so I think the first question is, can we confirm the starter packs have larger value, essentially, based on rarity? And yes, the contents of the game starter pack depends on rarity. So this is actually when the rarity of the NFTs come into play. At the game starter pack. So the queue will be based on rarity, the contents such as how many coins and diamonds and tokens and whatnot. Everything you need to play the game will come in the pack, and that will scale based on rarity, of course. But the exact contents, of course, is still TBD. It's pending the economy balancing. So one of the main points of the pre-launch is the economy balancing. So how much do things cost in the game? What is the value of a single gold coin or the value of a gem inside the game? How much effort do you have to work to get one card or maxed out legendary? All of these things are being balanced. The level up costs. So we can't put a number on it because if things have to change, then you know, then the number we gave you is kind of insignificant to what it is. But it all will be relative to what we originally had as our mint prices. So make sure that it's a relative amount or it's a significant amount compared to that. So you know we don't want to give away 5 cents of gems if the economy is somehow out of whack and we have to increase the number of gems it costs for things. So the exact number is TBD and it's being balanced along with the economy. So the game starter pack will get you guys going right away from day one. So that's the rarity based contents as well as the what's inside the game starter pack. The other part of the question is reset. Do I lose everything? Hopefully no. So the whole benefit of getting a head start is that you get to play, you start to accumulate stuff and we all become very attached to these things. So the intention is not to reset everyone at the end of pre-launch, but I have to put a caveat on this is if for some reason the economy just was out of whack, there's an exploit, there's a bug or something that's really like not right and we have to change the whole economy, we may need to reset. So it's a possibility. We might have to reset. There could be some head start that we give to anyone who joined during pre-launch, but our intention is not to reset. So anything you're collecting now, you would carry over to the game as well. In addition to the game starter pack.
Sorry, I was on mute. Okay, great. Thank you, James. I think that covered the rarity question as well. So actually, no, it didn't. So next question from JJJ, can we consider rarity for our multipliers so we have more sales of different rarity?
Yeah, so maybe it's sort of related to what I said, but for now, the value of the NFT rarity comes into play at worldwide release. So the number of tokens you get, the number of gold, the number of diamonds, what type of queue you get, all of that will depend on rarity. But for our simple version of the pre-launch, the rarity is not scaled, not considered. So it's not until the worldwide release when we have that game starter pack.
Okay, understood. Okay, and next question from CDN, list of gaming reward protocols. There are many teams building play-to-earn platforms to help gamers monetize their play. It's a great way to get new users while boosting existing players' earnings. If you know any of these, add them below so that the eyeball team can look into following up for a potential collab and getting eyeball into their play-to-earn platform. And firstly, thank you very much for pulling this list for us, CDN. Yes, we're aware of majority of the play-to-earn platforms. As we mentioned on last week's call, we have planned marketing beats to hit around 2 to 3 million wallets in September time. Our goal has always been to get engaged gamers. And, you know, we wanted to build a community around users that actually wanted to play our game for the inherent merit of the game itself, that it's actually fun, right? And so to that point, there are varying levels of quality of audience from a lot of these, from a bunch of sources online and a bunch of different questing platforms, right? Some are entirely incentivized and they're probably not the audience that we want, because we want to build a sustainable game, right? So our current plan is we're going to activate our marketing beats within this September time, targeting those 3 million wallets, and we're going to take stock and understand which of these channels actually drive engaged gamers, because we want engaged gamers. We don't want people who are just going to play to earn. So thank you for sending the list. We will look into that. But for now, our plan is just to activate the current beats that we have for September and then take stock at the end of the month.
Yeah, but if you guys know of any popular platforms that you guys believe we should be working with, yeah, keep them coming. So I know Beam, we have a partnership with them. We're working with them. We have our NFTs in their marketplace as well. Game 7 is also on our radar. So yeah, so if there's anything you guys think we should be partnering with, for sure, add it to us. But we do have a list of different game discovery sites and venues, and we're going to be working out different partnerships in some sort of staged rollout. So it's keep the growth and start to touch every community and bring them into our game.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you for elaborating on that, James. Yeah, and for, yeah, thank you very much for sharing that list as well, CDN. I wasn't trying to sound too dismissive. Okay, the final question this week was from, surprise, surprise, DeFi Hodler again. After launch, what is the value of the OG NFTs? Are they burnt? I think we kind of answered this one, haven't we, James? Are we just get queues in the game? Need more info on benefits of being a long-term holder well beyond launch.
It goes back to the previous one, similar. But yeah, for sure, these NFTs are not forgotten. We don't just get rid of them. They will still provide a value in the game. They will be part of your vanity aspects, as well as ad-free play. So there's still value, and it's also a tool for us to identify the cohort, the early supporters of the project. And when we have other types of projects, other game titles that make use of all the infrastructure that we built out, we would be able to identify those guys through these early NFT collections. So they would have early access as well. If that early access program had an airdrop, they would be eligible for those airdrop and boosts and scaling as well. If there was a game starter pack in the new game, there could be some claim of what you would need to get started on that new game. So for sure, we want to know who this community is, and we don't want to forget them, and we want to include them any chance we get. Because these early days of testing, it's very important for us to you know, have a good dedicated community that's around the game. That if we mess up, they're not, you know, the game's not going to get 1-star reviews, right? The guys understand that we're building something and it's early, and we get a lot of helpful feedback as we're developing. But yeah, so we definitely. We'll keep that in mind for any future titles.
Got it. Okay, I think we've run through all the questions, the pre-prepared questions. I'm just going to open up the chat. Okay, great. One question from Dodger Zen. I was wondering are you seeing these questions, by the way, James, on the chat, just in case you want to follow as well?
I'm on the general chat. If I go to the
AMA stream, you can press the open chat, the little chat bubble, and there's a question there. Yeah,
just AMA stream. Oh, open chat. Oh, fantastic. Yeah. I would click it and it tries to like hang up and go to the next. Okay, I see there are some chats. I see, yes. Dodger with a sticker.
I'm gonna read Dodger's. I was wondering if it would be possible to make the purchase of NFTs an incremental process for the bonus multiplier. For early investors and new players, it can feel like it's really hard to have to buy all the way to 11 to see a difference. It might turn them off past purchasing just one. I was wondering if it'd be possible to have a small increase, not huge or anything, but something that at least makes you feel like your money gave you a boost, at the very least a small one, maybe a few percent until it hits the next level when you get a big jump. This way you still want the next level, but at least you are getting a small boost for the money spent in the meantime while you work your way there. Yeah, I think it's a good question, Dodger. I think this came up before. So there are two mechanisms, right, in that bonus payout. Around the NFTs, and you know, there is the NFT collection, which obviously you get 30% for OG and 20% for the early access, and then the second one is the NFT volume collection, so how many NFTs you hold. And the way we balanced it, we genuinely feel that getting the 30% and 20% bonus up front is worth its while at first, and we don't really have any plans to change the first tier at this moment in time. I don't know if you've got anything to add to that, James.
Yeah. So I think the intention of this this bonus on the score was it was called the whale factor internally, right? So it's actually meant for people who are like obsessively collecting our NFTs. So it's not really a whale if you have a bonus for collecting two, right? You've got to be a little bit overboard and really obsessed with the project. But what I can say is it's in place there because it allows people to slowly collect as they find the floor price or the reasonably priced ball drives. Because it's not rarity based, you can just go out there and support, you know, support the sweep the floor of whatever's on the market when the price is in your range of what you're collecting. So this this multiplier, it's not it's taken at the snapshot. So you have from now all the way until the end of pre-launch to collect 11 if you wanted to hit that next tier. I encourage you to go out there, keep collecting all the ball drives that you think are interesting and add to that number to hit into the next bracket of the tier. But the whale factor is intended to be whale factor. So I think we think something like 11 or that 10 to 11 range is good for that first boost.
Great. Thanks, James. That makes sense.
Thank you, Doctor.
Mr. Goku, possible to increase the multiplier ceiling? There might be some crazy guy wanting to have more than 4, 5, 1 passes. You want to ask one, James? Because from my understanding, it was modeled based off their current distribution.
Yeah, so we did some analysis on the current distribution, and we kind of found a nice fair balancing for that. So we kind of scaled it accordingly. But it's actually kind of funny that Mr. Gold saying that, because a lot of our rules internally when we're developing something, a lot of the edge cases always turn out, you know, what about Mr. Gold Q? So there's an internal saying. Anytime we come up with something, is the question somebody raises their hand in the meeting and say, hey, what about Mr. Gold? Like, oh crap, that breaks the logic. We got to go and fix it. You thank you for your support, but you are obsessed with collections. We fixed the numbers, and we don't want to keep adjusting it and changing it throughout. We want to kind of fix it, set it. This is the way it is. Let's go forward. Because then things, you know, in the future, then everything is up for variations or changes. So we think it's currently fair based on the distribution that we saw. Feel free to collect more if you want. Remember to make use of all the other bonuses as well. So those referrals. And I think I'm one of Mr. Gold Q's referees. So whip your referees and make them work, make them hit those levels so you can further enhance your boost.
Indeed, I've got only like two friends. And they're not
very good. Yeah, get on that.
All right. So JJJ, I thought we actually answered your question. I think James answered it before, but maybe James, do you want to answer it again? So JJJ's question was, can we incorporate rarity on the current multiplier in game for getting gold points?
So the rarity will come into play once we have the game starter pack on the worldwide release. And the value that's included in that game starter pack does scale with rarity. So the actual original utility of the NFT does apply the rarity characteristics. But for pre-launch, not so much. So this encourages people to buy things from the floor, keeps the market active and healthy.
Great, thank you, mate. Not the starter pack, in-game gold calculation.
So the in-game gold gold score, I believe you're talking about the pre-launch score, Mr. J. He has one of my favorite legendary ball drawers there. The in-game pre-launch gold score, this is not based on rarity but on the number of OG NFTs that you collect. So it's the pure number. So this whale factor, if you have a whole bunch, that boosts you into the next level. Also, if you just hold one of each, one early access pass, one OG, you would get both of those stacked. So they're not independent of each other. Yeah, so it, in the gold score calculation, one legendary is equal to one common. But this is only for the gold score. This gold score is more performance-based, and performance not only in the game, but in the referrals as you bring other players into the ecosystem. But the value of those NFT rarities is inherent when the game is launched. Right? That legendary Q value, the amount of gold, the amount of gems, the amount of tokens that it has inside of it is the value of the NFT. But that's only at worldwide release. For pre-launch, we're all the same. Oh, right, sorry about the muting. It sucks to be muted.
I think so I guess to reiterate, James, is there is a difference between the rarity, and that difference is at the worldwide launch and the airdrop later, right? So worldwide launch, your rarity is going to yield you a Q of the respective rarity. And once the marketplace is up and running with the NFTs, you're going to get value back there again. And also the airdrop, which is separate to the 5% allocation here, that will be based on your rarity as well. So there is a distinction between them, just not on the pre-launch beta multiplier level. Type me anything.
Mr. J thinks it's easier to talk. So I think we're still like discovering this Discord platform and what works best for the MA. So I think we can talk with Yanni to see about the format, if this works, or how, if people can like request the mic. I don't know how to do that yet, but we could figure it out.
Sure. A couple of questions trickling in. Orion, did we discuss the IMX Gems quest hangup? We did. I think you joined late.
Yep. It's too late. We already discussed it. It's gone. So just a very quick summary. There were some technical issues with the wallet integration, passport wallet integration into layer 3, which prevented people from logging in. While they work on it, Immutable will be letting us go live on Friday with the main quest done manually. So it won't be using layer 3. And it will go for 3 weeks, so we get a lot more exposure. We'll get 100 gems or so for doing that. And then they will nominate us to go a second time once layer 3 integration with passport wallet is done. And then we'll have double the fun, right? Double the gems. So we'll be able to go again based on your progress in the game. So keep playing. All of your progress still counts, even from last week when the quest was kind of messed up. All your progress counts. So go ahead, play, and then we'll see on Friday when we go live with the main quest.
Got it. Next question double from dip. JJ. Yeah. Double dip. Buy one, get one free. In launch, does it have a gold calculation too, like the pre-launch? That's a quite simple no. The audience is, when we go to worldwide launch, JJJ is not just going to be the Web3 audience. We're going to broaden it out to the Web2 audience as well. So our goal is to, bring Web3 to a wider audience. So we won't have that gold calculation there.
If that question is about the game starter pack, yes, the gold is going to scale based on your NFTs. So that part is true, but it's not like the formula we're using for the pre-launch. The gold, the tokens, the gems, all that.
Okay, more advertising coming. Yes, as mentioned, GoQ, we have about 200 DAOs we're going to partner with. A couple of KOLs which are targeting like 200,000 users, and then obviously the Immutable partnership, so alpha calls. So on our media plan, we're hoping to reach about 2 to 3 million wallets. So yes, we have more advertising to come. Glow in the dark pool theme, will it be a thing? Is that I don't know.
Yeah, if that's, I think in the States, we have this midnight bowling, right? So they turn off the lights to put on the black lights, and all the balls are glowing, the pins are glowing. Same with golf and the driving range, we have this glow in dark. But yeah, there could be a cool theme around that on the tables, some blacked out version. So I'll get with the design team, just let them know that, hey, well, how would this work? Is that cool? A glow in the dark pool table cue?
Got it. We don't have that in the UK. We do actually. Sorry, I think we do have that, but it's not like pitch black dark. JJJ. Yeah, oh, yeah. So there'll be no leaderboard. There will be a leaderboard, JJJ. But in the worldwide launch, it's. I don't know how much we can talk about the feature set, but it's going to be. It's not going to be this huge universal leaderboard, you know, where you just see millions of players, because the challenge there is that if the frame of your universe is too big and you quickly lose interest. So instead, we're going to create sort of mini leaderboards. I don't want to talk about it too much. I don't want to spoil the feature launch, but there will be leaderboards, but they're going to be a lot more bespoke, a little bit smaller and more competitive.
Yeah. There will be leaderboards and leagues and competitions, all that good stuff. But it's different than what we're doing. What we're doing today is we're trying to like roll up and scale up the growth, so that everyone comes and tries out the game and get the head start.
Correct. Is Master Reyes playing the preseason? Is he crazy? Could be.
If you spell it backwards, it says Bata Reyes, right? crazy, you look in the mirror.
My favorite username at the moment is Bot Player. Whoever came up with that, I think, a very funny person.
And maybe it's him, who knows? Who knows? Maybe he's in the leaderboard. You guys don't know.
The 80s arcade graphics, that typical arcade carpet could be fun. Glow in the dark. Okay. Make special mythical cue for the glow in the dark theme. You like the glow in the dark a lot, don't you, Crypto?
I love it. I think it's cool. I love it.
Feels like nocturnal. Will the NFTs be included in calculation or just via the gold that we earn per game?
I think he's referring to the implementation at worldwide release. So this is still in development. So we don't have the exact specifications around the Masters League or whatever we're developing. It's still in development. So we can't comment on that just yet. But for the pre-launch, yes, the number of NFTs and stuff, it's all like the bonuses and the formula that we know and love. So it's but that's different.
Right. We'll bring more players. Okay. Well, the questions are slowly drying up, but I can see a few people typing. Yeah, we suggest that we include NFTs in calculation because it's still in development. This is still for the worldwide launch, JJJ.
Yes.
More questions and speculation aside, I just want the rest of the team know that I think the game is incredibly fun. I really enjoy playing, and I think you guys have done a really good job. Thank you, Dodger.
Thank you. Thank you for that. That really helps to hear that, right? Because we're going through a lot of stressful times and trying to meet deadlines, and we get a lot of rough treatment in Discord and every now and then. So I really appreciate that. It's really helpful for the team to hear that you guys are enjoying the game. You're having fun, and we open this community to hear your voice, let you guys give us feedback on how's the game, and answer all your questions. So that's what we're here for.
Indeed, we will pass that feedback back. All right. I think we're done this week. So just to recap, Friday, main quest goes live. Log on, get playing, complete the quest, earn gems. And I think we'll let JJJ have the last word.
Oh, make it good. No pressure. Please involve NFT. Yes, NFTs will be involved in the game for sure. But we can't give any spoilers on what we're developing, because there are some cool mechanics to the cues, the NFTs themselves, even the ball droid NFTs, how they're incorporated in the game. But we can't give any spoilers away on the feature sets of worldwide release. No hype. Yeah.
As long as it's there, I'm done buying. Be happy. Okay, that's a positive note. Let's leave it on that. JJJ is happy. I'm happy. James is happy.
I'm not done buying. Oh, crap. Okay.
Okay, guys, for the questions.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Have a good day, good night, good morning.
Yep. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.